They're gonna burn them out. I'm gonna make it safer to ride. Okay, this has gotta be it. Lisa, I'm coming for you. She's gotta be out here somewhere. Shit! That did it.
Jesus, don't sneak up on me like that.
Did you find anything out about Sarah, about the woman that I put in your chopper?
Hey, wait, it's gonna take some time, okay? I'm risking my neck here. If anyone back at HQ finds out, those guys with the guns over there,
you're all
the whole order
the
without
same
question.
Team, O'Brien.
Just looks that way. Look, I don't have time to explain it right now, but it's why I need your help.
My help?
Look, just take it. It's a wavelength recorder and some GPS trackers. I just need you to... We're out of time. Look, I don't even know your name.
Deacon St. John. Look,
Deacon St. John, if you want me to risk my neck helping you find whatever her name, Sarah, then yeah, I'm gonna need you to do something for me. Keep the radio close. I'll contact you in a couple of minutes.
Yo, close. It's been right here the whole time, you son of a bitch. Jesus Christ, how long do I have to wait now?
Hello? Are you there, Deacon?
Yeah, I'm here. Now, what's this all about? What do you want?
All right, I put a blocker on this channel. It's secure.
What do you want?
I've sent a series of coordinates to your radio. I need you to go to those locations.
Why? Then why don't you ask them?
I can't. Look, I said it's a long story, and I don't have time to get into it right now. Let's just say the men above me, way above me, are running a lot of field missions, all separate from each other. Nobody knows what anyone else is doing.
So the world ends, and you assholes carry on like nothing's changed. Where?
I sent you the coordinates.
Okay, Jesus, O'Brien. All right, I will see what I can do. Yeah, I got it, but you better have something for me, O'Brien.
Yeah, I got it too. Hold on.
O'Brien, I'm here. What do you want me to do? Sneak into an LZ filled with heavily armed Kevlar-wearing soldiers who shoot on sight so that you can spy on some asshole wearing a pocket protector?
Pocket protector? Really? I have a fucking PhD, asshole.
Yeah, which stands for piled high and deep.
You still
have
the tracking devices I gave you?
Not only was gonna sell them, but most of us don't have access to shit like, you know, satellites.
Yeah.
what's wrong. The boys were carving out the guts of a freak while I was okay, still alive.
Keep your eyes open. They're not my boys. What do you care? Aren't you a... What do you guys like to call yourselves? Drifters? Don't you kill them affected for money or whatever shit you partner with?
Yes. Yeah, I kill freaks, but I don't carve them open while they're still alive and listen to them scream.
Did you get my data?
Yeah, I got your data.
Okay, I'm uploading it now. I heard something. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Brian? O'Brien! God damn it, he did it again. O'Brien, talk to me. Business going, Sandy.
What do you want?
Deke, we got a problem.
Yeah, Tuck, what's up?
You remember Alkai said that Rippers were spotted, heading our way?
Yeah, I remember. He said he didn't try to stop them.
Well, we've seen them scout the hot springs. A couple of men followed him back to their camp in the cliffs south of the Twin Craters.
Goddamn Rippers. Don't worry about it, I'll take care of him. I got a score, so...
A score? What are you talking about?
Good, never mind.
Yeah, I can do that.
Deacon!
Hey, Danny. Keeping your hands clean?
We're gonna run out of this someday, you know. See ya.
Danny, I'll be back. Should work.
Hey, hold on.
What's your name, asshole? I'm killing you.
Get the gun!
Fucking piece, you son of a bitch.
He's trying to...
He sent you? Thank you.
those of us who are bound? No, we are their friends, their protectors. Guide them as they guide us.
Nope.
Fuck you, rest in peace, let me help you out.
Came by to see how the lazy bastard's doing. How you doing, Boozman? Are you tired of laying around yet? Boozer.
Hey, you can't be in here, Deacon. Come on.
Hey,
come
what's on, going Deacon. On? How's he doing?
He needs his rest.
Don't mess around with me, Eddie. I asked you, how was he doing?
I'm good. Not good. It's cold. They're not enough. Never enough.
Wait a second. You said that
I said that we would try. When all we can do is wait.
Okay. All right.
Deacon, stop. I know you want to smash something. I see that look in your eyes, but you know what? You go right ahead, but you do it out there.
Daddy,
go. Look. There is nothing else you can do. Please. Just go home. Go home, Deacon.
Deacon. So, you gonna make it? Yeah. Schizo, he'll be fine. He needs a few days.
Come with me to the lodge. I want to show you something.
I got shit to do.
I'm sticking my neck out here. Trust me. You're gonna want to see this. Just listen. A couple of months back, this drifter comes into camp, telling all kinds of crazy stories. Said he worked at the airport, was on the ground back in Farewell when shit went down. One night, they were expecting a flight in from Portland. Only it never shows up. The plane was doing the haul for the Red Cross.
The Red Cross.
Yeah.
Getting it? Medicine, doctor shit, cargo hold, full of it. Maybe even some of those whatever the fucks.
Antibiotics.
Yeah. Shit like that. Just like that.
Where?
Hey, keep your voice down, will you? Let's talk inside. So this drifter. He's working in the control tower when the plane disappears off the radar. Poof. Now you see it, now you don't. Right about here.
South of Mount Washington.
That's what he said. It came down intact. A controlled crash or whatever. The guy's got to listen to the pilot bleeding out from a broken pelvis on the ground.
Okay, so you haven't sent anyone to find this?
Nope.
Why not?
Because the old man won't have it.
Iron Mike, what the... Oh, right. Rippers.
You catch on quick. Everything west of the Iron Ridge here belongs to Carlos and his merry band of bald-headed freak-alikes. So you go over there and you get caught. You head north, brother. Otherwise, Iron Mike's treaty with Rest in Peace goes...
Yeah, I get it. Let me ask you a question. Why are you telling me this?
Wait a minute. First off, I'm not telling you shit. You remember that? Second off, you're a goddamn drifter. What am I supposed to do? Follow you around like I'm your little bitch, keep your ass out of trouble?
All right.
I have things to do.
I get it. You're just a regular stand-up guy, right, Schizo?
Just trying to stay alive. Like everybody else. Hey. You do what you gotta do. At the end of the day, that's all we got. Do you know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying, Schizo.
Keep your radio close. I'll be in touch.
Something new every day. Schizo, it's St. John. I'm at the border.
You see any of my men around?
No, Schizo, it's clear. Look, how much time do I got?
Time? Time for what? All I know is, I got a card game going on with a few of my guys. A couple of them maybe that should be out on guard duty, but I'm letting that slide. If I had to guess, I'd say we'd be playing all night.
So until morning. Got it, Deacon out.
He didn't die. That's crazy.
Thank you.
What he's surviving this. Bear trap, bro. Thank you.
tough. Son of a bitch.
Great antibiotics. You gotta find me some antibiotics. Bounties. Basil, fix him up, and then we ride out of here, head north, like he said.
Deacon St. John, are you there? Deacon, this is Ricky. Over.
Damn it.
Wait! That's Deacon. Behind him!
What's going on?
We had a run-in with a few rippers, but I handled it.
You handled it? What's the... How? I should have known.
You should have known what? Jesus, Ricky, who's running security here?
You know, I ask myself that shit every single day.
I'm done.
So what are you doing out here?
What am I doing, Dick? Addie told me to come and get you.
Why? Wait, hold on for a second. Is Bruiser okay?
I don't know. We gotta go.
What's wrong with Bruiser?
All I know is Addie told me to find you. When I asked around, I found out you and Skizzo were heading up here. Now I know why.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Exactly
what happened.
I remember it pretty clearly.
in against their will.
How about Tucker? Same thing true for her?
I don't know.
You ever think when you roll up on someone, starving out in the shit, maybe hasn't slept in days, reach the point where they stop running from men like you, you ever think they don't have a choice? Would you take them to the hot springs just to say, earn a few camp credits? Everybody's got a choice, Deacon. It takes us a lot, too, bringing in someone who can't work, can't earn their way. You know, you just be glad that Iron Mike isn't like you.
William! William, if you can hear me, I need you to stop! Addy, what's going on?
Boozer?
Go and hold him.
What the hell are you doing? What
listen,
are you doing?
Listen, we not need to do this, and we need to do this right now.
You what?
No. Don't you. Oh, don't no. you take
Deacon.
It!
No, no. Deacon. No, you're not. No way. You're not going
to
do this.
Deacon, listen to me. The antibiotics will save his life, but nothing on God's earth is going to save the arm. Now, listen, I need you to help me right now, or you can just watch your friend die.
Okay. Addy, we're losing him.
Wait!
Deacon.
All right. Hey, pal. All right, hey, I just need you to stay
hold
with
him.
Me.
Hold him there.
Okay.
Hold him.
Deacon.
Okay. Hold him down right there.
Okay. No, he's losing too much blood. You gotta stop. He's losing too much blood.
I need to go.
Boozer, come on, man.
Hold him.
Okay, pal, where do I hold him?
Just hold him like this. Stop panicking.
I'm trying.
Hey. You did good in there.
When I was in high school, I thought, maybe I should be a mechanical engineer, or should I be a surgeon? I guess I should have been a surgeon.
And you?
Hey, okay.
You know, you saved your friend's life today.
I don't think he's gonna see it that way.
Yeah, well, I think he will. I gotta go and give him his IV drip. And you know what? I don't know where you got all this, and I don't want to know. But it's going to save a lot of lives, Deacon St. John. A lot of lives.
I gotta go help Addy.
Mike, just settle down. Okay?
Deacon! Get out here!
Dang, you gotta do with everything.
I heard what you did.
Yep.
Wasn't about to let him die.
Mike, let it go. It's done.
I know that, goddammit. Who's there gonna live? I don't know. But the Ripper saw you. Followed you back. When Carlos finds out about this, there's gonna be the devil to pay.
Carlos can go fuck himself. You are writing checks with other men's blood.
I hope you're good with that.
I did what had to be done. Mike, wait up.
There with Iron Mike threatening to break my neck and all, but didn't have a choice. See, Boozer was gonna die, and, well, he still didn't want to go. Hell, I didn't want to go, but
Like I said, didn't have a choice. Neither of us did, so it didn't matter. He lost the arm anyway, and now he's stuck. I mean, we're stuck. Goddamn schizo. You know, I can't remember if I told you about this clown, but he's the kind of asshole that's glad all this shit went down. He says he was gangbanging in Sacramento and Fresno. I don't remember, but he says he's not from around here, and he's not. Claims he was dealing drugs and guns from California, Oregon, and then everything went to hell. And you know what? I think he's full of shit. To me, he kind of looks like a frat boy, like he was on the lacrosse team peddling sodas at a mini mart. No. He would have had a cushy job at his old man's accounting firm making copies and getting everyone their morning coffee, you know, making more in a day than I ever made in a week. You know, it's this game the boozer and I used to play before we wrote out a lost. They call it, who you were. You know, we'd look at someone, we'd try to guess who they were before the shit went down, you know. You know, I met a few drug addicts, a lot of ex-cons, no accountants. So, that makes sense, if you think about it. First couple of weeks after the shit went down, I mean, Jesus, that was a freak show. There's no way some accountant or pencil pusher lived through that shit, so I don't know, maybe Schizo was telling the truth. I'm not sorry that you missed it. I'm not. Anyway, Boozer and I wanted to head north and get away from all this shit, but that ain't happening anytime soon, or happening ever. Hey... Look on the bright side. Looks like you're stuck with me. Okay. I'll stop by later. See you.
One of the biker boys.
Hey, Ricky, you said you had a job for me?
Hey, Deke. Yeah. You remember Shane Riley? Everyone called him Red.
Red Riley. Yeah, never heard of him, but let me guess. Ginger?
What, red hair? No. It was his boots. He wore these rattlesnake boots dyed with god-awful red color. He made quite the impression.
No, I bet.
Anyway, he used to do runs for us back in the day until one day he decides he didn't like the camp credits we were paying. So he up and kills Lindsay Fuller.
Who?
Lindsay. Worked supply before Blair?
Wait a second, so he killed an unarmed woman?
Oh, she was armed. She just wasn't expecting him to shoot her in the face. Will you listen? So Red murders her, cleans out her supply hut, and then takes off before anyone knows what's happened. Got away clean.
Oh, that son of a bitch.
Until now. He and his men have been spotted up at Camp Pioneer.
You don't gotta ask. I got this thing about him.
About killing unarmed women. I know. So I knew you'd want to handle it.
Yeah, like I said, I got this covered. What else can you tell me about him?
Not much. Oh, wait. He chews tobacco. I heard he was such an addict that he rounds up cigarette butts, takes out the tobacco, and chews that.
Well, that's disgusting. So now I got two reasons to kill him.
Yeah, but be careful, Deke.
How's it going?
Just looking around.
You go through a lot of this shit, yeah? All right.
Okay, see you later.
Drifters, you guys murdered it!
Shit, Sam needs help.
Yeah! Keep on, run, 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 run.
There we go.
Deacon St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke! Hey, feeling a little out of it, you know. You okay? What's going on?
Booze. Hey, nothing.
I got this. Hang on. You want to die out here? Look, there's a camp that... Yeah. Head to Lost Lake. Ask for Ricky Patel. She'll take you in.
Thank you.
Name's Deacon. They know who I am. Stay off the main roads. Don't stop. There. Deacon St. John to Lost Lake Infirmary. Come back.
Deke! Hey. Feeling a lot of it, you know. You okay? What's going on?
Fucking wipe away, man.
Remember how Jack carved up that turkey?
Hey, Ricky, I'm a camp pioneer and it is a goddamn war zone.
What's going on? Are any of our guys there?
No, I don't think so. Sounds like they're clearing freaks. Don't worry. I'll find this guy. Deacon out. Where the hell are you? Newts. Oh, wow, they're killing newts.
More bounties.
Okay, what's this?
Okay, yes. Cigarette butts, yes. Boot prints. These look like the kind of prints that some fancy cowboy wants to make. Tobacco's bed. Red Barney, you are one gross motherfucker. Oh, good. Prince, yeah, this way. Box.
here. Good. You're in. Jesus. If you gotta go, you gotta go. Red. He's got it here somewhere. Thanks, thanks.
Been eating this? Hey, Ricky, I got him.
Deacon, what a relief. Lindsay has some folks she was close to. I'll let him know.
Yeah, okay. I'll see you around, Ricky. One of your beacons.
Which one?
What do you mean, which one? This Nero radio has a GPS, doesn't it?
Yes, of course it does. Okay. You're at Olali Falls. Okay, good. Keep an eye out. A field op's gonna be there any minute. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it. O'Brien, come in. Your friends are here. O'Brien. Follow armed Nero goons into a They don't.
Right over here.
I never got that.
Yeah, why is yours?
It's a stage 2, stage 3 thing.
What do you mean?
I mean, the virus is what it is, right?
No, it's more complicated than that. You know what I mean?
Okay. I know I'm a grunt. Before the freak show, I was a biology major. Just give me the gist.
Really?
Try me.
Okay. We don't really know, but blood tests show. The current evidence suggests that the virus spreads through the lymph system, reproducing and attacking cells on a catastrophic scale.
Attacking?
Not precisely. Expressing a series of dormant proto-oncogenes into an active state.
Cancer?
Look at him. Look at all of them. That looks like cancer to you.
Maybe you're really bad.
No. No, this is something far worse.
What do you mean?
This virus is on a mission. The freaks are what they are because the virus wants them that way.
What are you saying?
I'm saying... Jesus, what am I saying?
Terrorism? You're saying this was deliberate?
I don't know.
That's it. You're done. Yeah, okay. Time to get that load of Dodge.
What the hell is she talking about, O'Brien? About this virus, whatever the hell it is, or what it's doing? I want to know what the hell's going on, O'Brien. Why are they out here? What the fuck are you doing? O'Brien?
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
Open the gate. Open the gate. It's that drifter.
Yeah, I know him.
I worked at the Humane Society. When I was out of shit, I saw a bunch of freaks down the hole.
Deke, I've been thinking about what you were saying about doing something to make a difference around here, pay back the camp. I'm listening. Do you got a few minutes? I'm gonna show you something.
Yeah, guess I can spare you a minute or two.
So where are we heading? You ever been out to the caves north of the lake?
I know. Come on, see if you can keep up.
Okay, let's go. I got marsh duty anyway this morning. Gotta see if any freaks are stuck in the muck out that way.
When's the last time you went up there?
Been a few years, I guess. When I was a boy, we used to live in that damn cave. The old man sort of fancied himself a geologist.
Sounds like we got a couple. Freaks stuck in the muck.
Yeah, sounds like. Here, let me take care of them.
All right.
You're not gonna let you do that.
Dan, I'm back.
Nice work. I think Schizo's just found a new man for the job.
You know what Schizo can go do.
Anyway, as I was saying, we spent hours talking about how all these caves were formed when lava flows would harden on the outside, but the molten cores would still flow like buried rivers. You got the big caves that drew in the tourists, like Metolius up there. There's way more than that. Riddled all over these parts.
Okay, we're coming up on the highway. We gotta be quiet. Jesus Christ! This is why you brought me out of here? Smell a bunch of goddamn freaks?
Yeah. Okay.
Come on, follow him. Wait. Follow him? Where the hell are we going?
You'll see. Come on.
Don't get too close. Stay down.
Jesus.
This doesn't seem all that smart, even for a goddamn drifter.
Hold up. You remember telling me about how the tourists used to flood up from California in the summer, choke off Highway 97 and the I-5 freeway?
Yeah, in July, folks smelled almost as bad as these here freaks.
But you weren't wrong about one thing. These freaks, the big groups, the ones that some call hordes, I think they're the reason we can't get their numbers down. Think about it, man. I've been out here in the shit collecting bounties for more than a year. Loser 2, Ricky, Schizo, a few others. How many freaks you think I carry?
A few,
yeah, but their numbers never go down.
You got a point?
It's these hordes. Every night, there's a steady stream of them up and down the Sandium Highway. Thousands of freaks pouring into the Lost Lake Valley north of the Cascades.
And you think they're coming up from California? Highway's closed off. No one's been south of the Sentium Pass in years.
It's not closed off to the hordes. Freaks are the reason it's closed off. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that the hordes come in every night. Not a goddamn thing we can do to stop it.
Well, you got that much right. Lost more than a few men trying to back in the day.
Yeah, I know. I was there. And every horde that comes through leaves a few stragglers or gets busted up and scatters. And just like that, freaks everywhere, as far as the eye can see.
You don't need to see them to know that they're around.
We figure out a way to stop the hordes coming through. Maybe we can make some headway, reduce their numbers.
Make it safer. Free up more farmland, irrigation.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we do that? You know goddamn well you can't take on a horde?
This is how. I'll be goddamn. Yeah. They stand there all day, hibernating or whatever the hell freaks do.
So what are you thinking that we...
Yep. Blow it the hell up. Stick it down right there. There and there, we bring down a mountain of rock, we seal this shit up.
Yeah, so we trap a few hundred inside. What good is that gonna do?
No, you don't get it. We seal this cave. Maybe they don't got no place to sleep. Or maybe this trail of piss and shit dries out, goes stale, and others stop coming.
All right. You get my attention. Okay, come on, let's head back.
Warmed up a bit. Let's see if you can keep up.
Yeah, okay.
Tell me, when does being out in the shit make you an expert on freaks? You spend your spare time just following them around, seeing what makes them tick?
Not exactly.
And how do you know about all this? About what a horde's gonna do, where they sleep?
few days ago, I was riding north of Belknap Crater when a chopper flew by.
A chopper? What the hell?
Just listen to me. It was a black chopper. One of those Nero choppers that used to fly all over the goddamn place when the shit was going down.
And you saw one, still flying?
I followed him. I stole one of their radios. I've been trying to track him down, see if they have a base around here. Supplies. Shit, I mean, see if the feds are still alive, you know what I'm saying? They're out here doing field work of some kind on the freaks. They're studying them.
They got resources to do that while we're out here starving. Fighting to stay alive.
I followed him up to the Grotto Caves. You know the ones?
Yeah.
They have motion sensors set up, measuring how many freaks use the cave during the day, and, Mike, it was thousands.
That right.
They said freaks all up and down the Cascade Range, south of Crater Lake, and north up to Smith Rock all use these lava tube caves to hibernate. So, we blew up those caves. Maybe we have a few less to deal with.
Hey, this idea of yours, it's got some merit, but a job like that, it's gonna take a fair amount of TNT.
He said you wanted help making Lost Lake safer. This is how we do it.
All right. Look, there's some things I gotta do, okay? But you meet me at the bridge in a couple of minutes. I know where we can find some.
Place is gonna be crawling out of. I don't think this is a good idea.
Weather holes will be safe enough. All right. That there? It's the old federal building. That's where we're headed. Let's not go looking for trouble. Stay out of the buildings. Come on. We gotta head over this way.
Where are we headed?
Just follow me. He'll be on the commissioner.
And you know where he is? Where his body is?
Yeah, I think I do. You heard what happened here.
Yeah, everybody got wiped out, man, woman, and child. Only a few got out, and you were one of them, right?
Only two got out, me and Nora. But it wasn't the freaks that took us out.
What do you mean?
Here. Say was gone. Two sides called a truce. A meeting. Right here. Oh, we knew what was coming. We knew what was coming and we were prepared. Fight didn't last long. But it was bad. They had ammunition left after all, and well, they... Oh, hell, you can see what they did. Like I said, two people walked out of this town after all was said and done. Some days, I wish to hell one of them wasn't me. Commissioner's over there in the bean counter suit. Go get the key so we can get the hell out of here.
You didn't give a damn about sealing the caves. You brought me here you brought me here because you wanted me to see this.
Not true. All right, you got the key. We're gonna go get the maps to those mines, just like I said, and we're gonna get more than enough TNT to seal every cave in the valley.
Bullshit. You are right about one thing. I'm not sorry you've seen it. Not following you, Mike.
I am talking about the war that's coming. With the Rippers. The one that Schizo saw. Don't you think he cares how many die on either side?
Never mind. Come on, let's get this done. Here's the door.
Place is locked up tight.
Come on. Try to find a way upstairs.
Smells like something died in here.
News. Yeah, I smell them. Bad business. Never much like kids. They always tended to get on my...
Okay. All right, this is it. Now we got maps to every mine in the county showing where they stored their dynamite. Okay, come on.
You hear that?
Yeah.
Are you expecting anyone?
Nope.
Do you have my back here?
Hey, I don't like starting trouble, but... Finish it if I have to.
Stay behind me.
Hey, I could take care of myself.
I'm not saying you can't, but remember the last time that we were out in the shit.
Yeah, like I said, I'm staying behind you.
Thank you.
Jesus, what a mess!
Now you know why no one goes into Sherman's camp.
Addie finds out you're out here risking your ass like this, she's gonna be pissed!
How would she find out about something like that?
Not from me. Rippers, why'd you want me to see that shit?
Nothing. I always saw a bit of myself in. Back in the day.
How's that?
Don't give a shit. All you care about your friend. Don't want to see him die, but me? Any other goddamn person on the planet, I don't think so.
Caring will just get you killed.
Schizo, he wonders why I'm a pacifist. That's what he likes to call me. He thinks I'm gonna get everybody killed. Mike, are you gonna get everyone killed? Freaks aren't gonna be around forever. Now, when they're gone, we're gonna need some folks around here to help pick up the pieces. Hey, look. I don't like Carlos and his rippers any more than I like Tucker or Copeland and his goddamn truthers. All right, but here's the thing, Deke. I'm not going out of my way to kill any of them. I've had my share of killing.
Even if Carlos comes for you?
My truce will hold. You can bet on that.